The original affluent society. This one's a popular example of how the spread of Western capitalism to most of the world is not necessarily the same thing as progress. Well, it's not progress. So there's hunter-gatherers, aka foragers, people who make a living by hunting animals, gathering crops, and sharing what they got with their communities. Hunting and gathering came before agriculture and long before societies that had states and laws that were written down. There still are hunter-gatherers today, but they're usually under intense pressure to become part of the global capitalist economy. Because their way of doing things came first, they're sometimes seen as being the most so-called primitive or like underdeveloped kind of society. But in the 60s, Marshall Solins and other anthropologists started to argue that hunter-gatherers were likely the original affluent society, as Solins put it. According to him, hunter-gatherers kept themselves safe, sheltered, and fed by working 4 or 5 hours a day. In other words, they work a lot less on average than people in so-called advanced societies, and as a result, they tend to be healthier and happier. Solins put this argument together based on an aggregation of a lot of different studies and a lot of different groups, and like any theory this broad, there's plenty of room to poke holes in it, so some critics have said that he painted like too rosy of a picture of hunter-gatherer life. He kind of glossed over hardships and simplified the 4-hour workday part, some say, because it's not like they actually put in a shift and then go home. They just do a total of about 4 or 5 hours of work throughout the day, right, at various moments, kind of mixed in with everything else. So maybe it feels more like you're always working. Now, I'm not a specialist in this, and the video's 2 minutes long, so I'm not going to take a position on these debates, but I will say the important points, I think, still stand. The most important point is hunter-gatherers are not simple or backward or uncivilized, whether or not they work more or less than people in capitalist societies. And capitalism was not progress in terms of freeing us up from the work of survival. Maybe that point about feeling like you're always working sounded familiar. Multiple unstable part-time jobs adding up to not really much of an income. Being on call, being on contracts, the gig economy, etc.